Welcome to another video of 3Devo. My name is Timo and I've got an important announcement to make. After 8 years, we are finally launching our second generation Filament Maker, the Filament Maker 2. During all these years, we've been collecting feedback from over 1,500 customers all over the world, ranging from universities, R&D departments and labs, medical industry and the automotive industry, that have all been using the Filament Maker 1 to develop new 3D printing materials or turn their plastic waste streams into new filaments. Many have already been very successful with the Filament Maker 1, where others have had many limitations. Our team of engineers have taken all this feedback into account and developed a solution that would fit for both groups, actually. So this would bring small-scale filament production to the next level. In this video, I will talk you through what we actually improved and why it is the answer to your filament making problems. But before we jump into it, I want to say one last thing. The purpose of the company 3Devo is to enable as many 3D printing material innovations as possible. Really taking 3D printing to the next level. And we understand that innovation will and should happen continuously. That is why we wanted to make the machine as future-proof as possible. And how did we do that? We actually did that by making the machine a platform. So over the years, on request, we could always add add-ons if you hit limitations of the machine. And also the software of the machine is open source API. So you will always be able to enable new innovations. Or just let us know and our engineers will develop a custom solution for you. So let's start with the core of the machine, and that is the extrusion system. The extrusion system makes sure you have a stable output resulting in a consistent filament diameter. And this consistent filament diameter is of course very important if you want a good quality 3D print in the end. So I'm going to walk you through the features of how we achieved this actually. So I want to start with the motor and gearbox combination first. Of course, it's hidden behind the panels, but in there is a very powerful stepper motor, which is 3 times more powerful than the previous edition. And it's also much more stable in the RPMs. So this will result in a stable screw rotational speed. And of course, this will result in a stable output. And let's start with the hopper then. So this is where the pellets enter the machine. And as you can see, it doesn't flip over when you just touch it. Very obvious, but also it has an active cooling system. So preventing materials with a low glass transition temperature, such as PETG, for example, from lumping together. Also, because of its round design, you have less issues like rat holing or bridging when working with shredded materials, because not all input is nice little pellets or balls. Recycled materials have very a rough surface and it really clumps together. So we solved that with this new design. Then another improvement is we made the screw longer. So with this more optimal LD ratio, you will have better mixing capabilities, better melt homogenization, and more pressure buildup. So this will also enable you to process more difficult materials with a more stable mixing output, basically. So besides this, there's a couple of heaters around the barrel, also hidden behind the panels, but these are also much more powerful, enabling you to reach the set temperatures much faster. So this will reduce any time that you would normally take in setting and dialing in the set parameters for the machine. This will really speed up the process a lot. Okay, let's move on to the front of the machine. So the nozzle is hidden very well. It's where the hot filament comes out. And as I said before, you can see it's insulated so well. And there's also no risk in filament forming around the nozzle, forming a huge blob, and potentially ruining your machine. Now it comes out properly and it gets cooled down by the filament fans. These might look familiar, but the cooling path is extended, so it has more time to cool down before it reaches the sensor. And the filament sensor, I have to say, is maybe the biggest improvement on the machine so far, and it's quite revolutionary, I have to say. Where the previous model just had a one-axis optical sensor, this machine has a three-axis high-speed camera system. So the resolution is already 5 times higher than the previous machine, but it also does 25 measurements per second, whereas the previous machine just did 1 per second. So, like I said before, since the machine is future-proof, this sensor is also very future-proof, because, like you can imagine, it's a camera system. It records images of the filament that passes through. So this way you can sort of capture anything that's going on your spool. For example, if there's contamination, you see a little blob in your log, you can know exactly what it is from now on. So what we've already seen is that you could really achieve industrial tolerances, of course, depending on the material. So then another point, and that is the puller mechanism. So these are the two wheels, as you can see right here, clamping the filament and stretching the filament to the right thickness, depending on the readings of the sensor. So what we've seen before is that these wheels, they can really squish the filament or they quickly wear out. So that is why with this button, you can easily adjust the clamping tension of the puller wheels on the filament. So really making sure that the filament doesn't get flattened and stays perfectly round. So then also the material of the puller wheels, we've made some changes on that, because some materials, they pass through this device with a temperature of over 400 degrees Celsius. And that could of course cause low temperature materials or low temperature puller wheel materials to quickly and easily wear out. So that is why we used a high temperature silicone to cover these puller wheels so they can last much longer. So then, assuming you have a high quality filament that is produced by the extruder and the puller mechanism, it's ready to be spooled. So this is one of the things that makes our machine so interesting. You have a very compact solution instead of a very long horizontal production line, which is more common for filament production. But one of the challenges is you need it to spool neatly. Like, for example, here. You want the layers to connect very nicely and don't entangle. And this way it gets printed quite easily. So when it comes out, you of course need to have the right spooling speed. And this time we enabled an automatic feeler arm, as they call it. And this adjusts the speed accordingly and keeps the right tension on the filament to not stretch it, but also keep pulling it properly. So then, as you already saw it, one of the biggest eye catchers is of course you can now process filament on big 3 kilogram spools, or maybe even bigger, as long as they fit on air. And how they fit on there is also much easier. So there's basically a chuck mechanism, so you just chuck it on there and it's stuck. And this makes spool swapping and starting up of your extrusion process much faster and easier. So I've covered the basics of how the extrusion mechanism works and how you create your spools of filament. But how do you control this machine actually? So as you can see, it has a touchscreen control display right now. So you can see much more about what is going on. And since it has an onboard computer, you can control much more parameters just from your screen. And you can see what happened throughout the entire spool rather than only seeing that on your computer when you connect it. About that, actually, you can now connect the machine through Ethernet connection and soon as well through Wi-Fi connection, and even control the machine from your PC. So that also means that if you have several filament makers or maybe a whole production line of 20 filament makers, you can all control them from your computer and always see what is going on. And this could be very efficient if you are using the machines on a regular day basis. Now I'm already coming to the last part of what we changed about the filament maker, and that is the fact that it's much more forgiving and easy to to disassemble and repair it. Because this machine is used in research so much, and also, for example, in universities, when students are working with it, stuff breaks, of course. And this time we took that into account, and you can easily access any parts that are inside with easily removable panels and no more glass wool insulation, but easily Velcro tape jackets around the heaters. Much more safe to disassemble. And this way, when something breaks, you won't need to ship the machine all the way back to us, but most of it you can actually do yourself. We just ship some spare parts and that's it. You minimize some downtime and it's much less scary to work with the machine as well. So then the most important part of this is actually the screw. Since it's used in research so much, being able to pull out the screw is crucial for many experiments, because some people really want to see the melting behavior throughout the screw, and now you can actually. But also, if you don't want any contamination in your extruder, which is sometimes important for research purposes, or if you are processing a medical grade material, it's actually absolutely crucial to not have any contamination. So now you can pull out the screw relatively easily from the front and clean out all the components that are in touch with the polymers. This is also very useful if the screw gets stuck. For example, if you went too far with your experiments, you added too many additives, and the only way is to pull out the screw. So this will give you much more control over your own projects. So that was it for now. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you're interested, feel free to reach out to us, and one of our material specialists will get in touch again with you to really consult you and what you actually need for a project, because every project is unique. No material is the same. Plastic is not a plastic. The list goes on and on and on, but you get what I mean. We will help you find the best solution for you. And if you're already an existing client and you already have Filmmaker One, we can arrange something to upgrade more smoothly to the next generation Filmmaker. So make sure to like and subscribe, because we got many more interesting videos in the pipeline for you to watch about the machine, some interesting innovations coming up, and very cool material innovations. So this way you can really stay in tune for the world of filament making innovations.